Do you know what does it mean to have a camera of these specifications? Or to have a specifications of phone camera on a website like GSM Arena to be like this one? Let's check this out together. Firstly, if you don't know how camera works and the meaning of something like shutter speed, check it firstly from the previous video up here in cards. Now we will start with each number separately. Firstly, for a 108 megapixels, the megapixel refers to the number of small picture elements in a photo called pixels. These are usually really tiny dots or squares that make up a complete digital image. A million of pixels are known as a megapixel. Megapixels are essentially the building blocks of a digital image. These blocks are arranged in rows and columns similar to a chessboard, but on a much smaller scale refers to pixel size below. If an image has 12 megapixels, it is very likely that it was captured on a sensor with 12 million or more photo sites. Remember, there are a million pixels in 1 megapixel. Therefore, a 12 megapixel photo is made up of 12 million pixels. This is known as the resolution. The more megapixels of a smartphone camera has, the higher resolution of photo it produces. So, a high resolution camera of 108 megapixels can give you an image with a more clear detail than a low resolution camera. For f over 1.7, this is the aperture, which is the adjustable opening between the lens and the sensor that controls how much light reaches this sensor. How wide or narrow the aperture is expressed in f numbers. A low f stop, like f over 2, means a wider aperture than that of a higher f number, f over 16. The lower the f stop, the more light your smartphone camera can capture. And obviously, more light means better pictures than the previous ones. Notice in the beginning I said typically aperture is adjustable. That's because it's how aperture works on traditional cameras, but on smartphone cameras, the aperture is fixed and the f number varies from phone to phone. Some phones have a fixed aperture like f over 1.7 or even as low as f over 1.4. But sometimes, like in Samsung S10, the f stops is changing from 1.4 to 2.4, so it is adjustable. For 1 over 1.33 inch, this is the sensor size. It's the device that makes the light that enters the camera and produces a digital image from it. It's pretty much the replacement for the photographic film. The size of the sensor is important because the bigger the sensor, the more light it can potentially receive. The more light it can receive, the better the picture quality. This is especially important in smartphone cameras because of their size limitation. 0.8 micrometer. This is the pixel size. We have already spoken about pixels and megapixels previously in this video. What these particular specifications refer to is the size of each pixel found on the sensor. The pixel size is one of the important things you need to look out for when you're buying a new phone for its camera. A camera with a sensor that has a large pixels is more desirable because the bigger the pixels are, the most likely you are to get great picture quality from this camera. 13mm ultra-wide. This is the focal length measured in millimeters. The term focal length refers to the distance between the camera's image sensor and where light coverages and focuses the image inside the lens. However, the measurement given in most smartphone camera specifications as 26mm full frame equivalent and not the actual focal length of the smartphone's camera, which is much smaller. A lens's focal length gives you an idea of its angle of view. A short focal length is great for shooting landscapes with your phone camera because it gives you an ultra-wide angle of view that captures more of the scene. The longer the focal length of a lens is, the more magnified your subject will appear and the less the scene you will see in the frame. This is perfect for portrait photography where the attention is on the person only. In a lot of cases, the rear cameras on the smartphones with multiple cameras have lenses with different focal lengths. The focal length of the primary rear camera is 26mm, which is typical of a wide-angle lenses. Larger focal lenses mean a reduced angle of view and a more magnification, as is the case with the telephoto lenses. Ultra-wide-angle lenses have an even wider angle of view than wide-angle lenses because they have a smaller focal length such as the 13mm ultra-wide lenses. In a single-camera smartphones, the camera has a wide-angle lenses. Dual camera smartphones have usually a wide angle lenses and a telephoto lens, but other combination exists. The focal length and the angle of view of these lenses differ from phone to phone according to the manufacturer. For the OIS, this is a type of image stabilization which refers to the way a mobile camera reduces the camera shake in order to avoid motion blur that is associated with camera movement while a photo is being taken. This contributes to the overall picture quality. Image stabilization can be achieved mechanically, which is OIS, or digitally, EIS, or through a combination of both, AIS. Optical image stabilization, OIS, counters the slight movement and shake of the camera by moving the image sensor or the lenses using a gyroscope. This counter movement helps reduce the amount of blur in your pictures introduced by an unsteady handling. Electronic image stabilization, EIS, is more of a software reliant post-processing effect rather than a mechanical function. And because of the way it works digitally, it is best suited for capturing stable video with a smartphone. A note that AIS stands for Artificial Intelligence Stabilization and is mostly not any different from EIS. 2x optical zoom. For the longest time, smartphone cameras were only able to zoom in digitally. The problem is that digital zoom degrades the picture quality more and more the farther you zoomed in. Pixelation becomes an issue because with digital zoom, the camera basically crops the image and then digitally expands it to fit the frame. In an effort to improve picture quality when zooming in with a mobile camera, smartphone cameras added optical zoom to their cameras when they introduced phones with multiple cameras. Optical zoom is far better than digital zoom because it uses the lenses to zoom, thus preserving picture quality. But unfortunately, phones with only one camera cannot zoom in optically. HDR. HDR stands for High Dynamic Range. It allows you to capture images that have a great balance between the dark areas of the photo, which is known as shadows, and the lighter ones, which is known as highlights. This way, the resulting picture will neither be overexposed nor underexposed. When HDR is enabled, the camera takes multiple pictures at different exposure levels. Then, with software technology, the photos are combined into the final composite photo with balanced highlights and shadows. O2 HDR means that the camera can analyze the scene on its own and determine whether it has very dark and very light areas in the same shot. If it does, HDR will automatically be enabled when the photo is taken. 2160p at 30fps. This is the video resolution and the frame rate, where the video resolution refers to the number of the pixels that a video has in each dimension. Similar to image resolution, 2160p is a 4K, while 1080p is full HD and 720p is only HD. The number between 8 and FPS refers to the frame rate of the video measured in frames per second, FPS. A typical movie has a 24 FPS, which essentially means in each second, there are 24 moving images displayed in succession. The higher the frame rate, the smoother the video appears. 60 FPS is commonly used in smartphone cameras. Videos with low frame rates appear to lag and suffer from motion blur. High frame rates such as 960 FPS are perfect for slow motion videos. With 960 images taken in 1 second only, you can slow down the video quite a lot and still have a crisp, fluid, slow motion action with little motion blur.